This episode's a little bit special. Not for being an anniversary or a particular milestone. The thing is, when I set off on this path, I knew I needed two things. Opening and closing music, and a test I could safely discard. For the music, I wanted something generated by the Famicom, but I also didn't want it to be something that could generate copyright strikes. The easy solution there was to compose it myself, and since I didn't have the keyboard for Konami's Disk System music title, Ikenarty Musician was it. And since I was going to be fiddling with it and figuring it out anyways, why not record the video and see what happens? So here I am, 6 months later, back at the beginning. And there's one thing that the process taught me. Ikenarty Musician is an absolutely awful way to generate music on the Famicom. When you start it up, you're presented with this interface, which is incredibly confusing. We'll start with the first thing you need to do, get a backing track. To do that, move the hand cursor until it's on this arrow and hit A. On the world map, you go onto one of these dots and hit A to start up its song. It's about a 5 to 10 second loop that will repeat. Selecting Japan brings up a bigger map that has several musical options. There's also a secret option if you press down from Mexico. It takes you out to the middle of the ocean for some relaxing wave sound. The one that's weirdest to me is how Scotland plays Scotland the Brave. The backing track I use for my opening is rock, and for the ending it's canon. Once you've got a bit of music you want to use playing, hit select to go back to the keyboard and mixer. You go between the mixer controls and the keyboard controls by hitting select as well. On here, the five blocks at the top show you different Famicom sound channels. The first one is reserved for the notes that you play, and the other four are used for the backing track. You can turn them on and off individually. Below that is this spot where you can choose what synthesized instrument you'll have. The one and two are for when you're playing a duet. You can assign the instrument separately. On the final row, you have controls for modulating the sound, though I can't tell the difference. From left to right, there are choking, vibrato, tremolo, portamento, and then auto phrases. The mic starts the recording process, and then the tape recorder plays back whatever you've recorded. Using the keyboard is not simple. Pressing left and right jumps a huge amount on the keyboard. Pressing up and down moves one note. Not all notes are available for all instruments either. Pressing A plays the selected note, and pressing B trills around the note. The thing is, there's a little bit of a delay when you change notes, and it makes actually playing a song effectively impossible. The best you can do is noodle around, stepping up and down the keys. One more thing about the keyboard. It extends off the right-hand side. If you go to the far right, it jumps back an octave to let you play some more notes. The duet mode lets you play with another person, and versus computer just makes the computer play a duet with you. The thing is, only one person can play notes at a time, so you can just step all over whoever's playing with you. The final option from the main menu is piano mode, and all that does is not let you choose a backing track. One thing they did put in Ikenarty Musician are some weird graphics and visualizations. If you press the circle in the upper right-hand corner, it makes bubbles appear when you press a key. And on the title screen, if you press AABB right left select, the word boy appears, and then you can press right and left to choose different color schemes. You've got boy, girl, old, and black and white television. Ikenarty in the title means spontaneous, or surprise, or suddenly. It's meant to imply that whoever picks up this software will suddenly become a musician. This one's infamous for infuriating people who bought it hoping to get something where they could write out music or at least play notes cleanly. And as a result of not being able to do anything really with the software, it's become known as Surprise, Not a Musician.